Okay, CPU. So components of CPU. So components do actions. So they perform actions. See, these are the logic units of the CPU. So we have got the control unit that performs a fetch execute cycle. Moves data around, synchronizes things. We have got the arithmetic and logic unit. So that performs, as its name suggests, arithmetic operations, which includes shifts, but it also does logic, so comparisons. Subtract and or not, those sort of things. And then the third component is memory cache. Okay, so that obviously holds memory and works out what memory to keep in the cache and from main memory and so on. Okay, and then we've got registers. Now there's loads of registers, but the ones that we consider are the program counter. Hang on. That's it. Just move that correctly. So we've got the program counter, and all that does is holds the address of the next instruction. That's all it does. Registers don't perform actions, they hold data. Right, okay, so that's where the CPU starts executing. So when you turn on a computer, the program count will be zero, so the first instruction will be fetched from memory lo address zero, which will in general be ROM location. Okay, which is why we have some read-only memory. To access an instruction in memory, we need to put its address in the memory address register. So this holds the address of the memory location we want to access, we want to read from, or we want to write to. So that's connected to the address bus. So that a value in the memory address register informs memory which location we want access to. Okay, when we receive a value with an instruction or a piece of data, it will arrive at the memory data register. Okay, so that holds data and instructions that have been fetched. So fetch from memory. So remember when we say fetch, we mean read. At that point, if we've got an instruction in there, the control unit can decode it. The only other register we need to worry about is the accumulator, which we often shorten to ACC. And that holds results of calculations. It's that sort of temporary area. So the things that the ALU has done. That's why we often in a diagram associate with the ALU. So the arithmetic and logic unit. So we had to add numbers together or do subtraction or multiplication, and the result will be held in an accumulator. Okay, so registers, they don't perform any actions. You should never say that. They just hold values, which maybe instructions, maybe data, depending on what that register's purpose is. So these are just super fast, dedicated storage locations on the CPU. Okay, and then the other thing to talk about is the fetch execute cycle. So this is the process that the control unit performs from the moment it's turned on to the moment that you remove power. Okay, and it follows these basic steps. So we transfer the program counter to the memory address register because the program counter's got the address of the instruction we want to fetch. We then perform a read, so we do a fetch. So the value at the location in the memory address register is read. And it comes along the data bus. And it arrives at the MDR. So the MDR holds instruction. So that's the fetch part. So we describe that part of this cycle as the fetch. Then the control unit then decodes. The instruction that's in the MDR. And then once it works out what it is, it can then perform the execute. At some point in this step, so here, we need to increment the PC. So that it's always pointing to the next instruction. So it's always pointing to the next instruction. And the reason that's important, and we have to do that before we execute generally, okay, because as soon as we've executed the current instruction, we do this whole process again. We go right back to the start. That's why it's called a cycle. So the PC needs to have been changed. Otherwise, you'll just fetch the same instruction. Okay, so that's the fetch execute cycle part. And then the von Neumann bit. The features. It is shared memory for instructions and data. But also, they're both in the same format, so instructions and data are both held in binary. Which has some interesting advantages. You can treat data as instructions and instructions as data, depending on what you're trying to do. And then you have the single execution or control unit that performs the fetch execute.